Greetings, friends, and welcome to another lovely Turtly Tuesday. Let's go ahead and see what we're doing today. None other than the NECA Mouser Cartoon Pack. This one, I believe, was a NECA store exclusive. I don't know if it's going to be in retail. I don't know yet if it's going to be in retail, but let's get this open and see what all it has to offer. Toast. First, let's take a look at the box. We got some samples of ways that you can position the mousers on the right there. And then three other sets that it outlines here are the Super Bebop and Mighty Rocksteady. I have those ones, so we'll have to do a video about those. Usagi Yojimbo. I've seen online that some people have gotten that one already, because that was one you get through the NECA store also. I've ordered mine, but it has not arrived yet, so I can't wait to get that one. And then the last one is the Cartoon Toka and Razar pack, which I still have not been able to find, but I hope to find it someday soon. All right, so the first thing the Mousers come with is a backdrop of the Technodrome. Somebody else recently came with this exact same backdrop. Who was it? Was it Mutagen Man or somebody like that? Oh no, I think it was Antrax and Scumbug came with this, except it was bigger. This is a smaller backdrop because it comes in a smaller box. So that is interesting. Now here's how the Mousers look in the plastic, and in the back there are a bunch of rats for them to eat. Oh, look at this. It's that little happy one. I think that came with Splinter. So we have a new one of that character. So first off, we have a slice of pizza. That's one of the same ones that came with the Turtles in Disguise pack. We have a little block of cheese for the rat to carry. We have a VHS tape down there at the bottom. And then one of those little copter drone things. That is an interesting addition, especially because it is so very small. Here is the happy rat, and looks like he's able to hold the cheese. And he seems to be a slightly different color than the one that we've gotten before. The rest of these look more like the Rat King's rats. And some of them, I believe, are the same exact ones that came with the Rat King figure. It looks like there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them, except I think the Rat Kings were a darker gray. These are a lighter gray. Let's get these open and compare them. Toast. All right, so here are the two rat figures. They appear to be the exact same sculpt, but they are painted quite differently. The one on the right with the pink tail is the one that came with Splinter. The one on the left with the brown tail is this new one. You can see the new one has just blank black pupils or black eyes, whereas the one on the right has cartoony white eyes with black pupils. So that is a difference there. Also, the more purpley hands and feet on the original one, and of course the gray fur color. So even though they are the same sculpt, they are indeed a variant of the same figure, which is kind of neat. Now here are the rats. Now on the far left you see the gray one. That's one of the rats that the Rat King figure came with. And you can see they repainted it for this pack. Also those two at the top with the curled tails, those are also repaints of the other two that the Rat King came with. And then we have these two new sculpts, the one that's ducking down and the one that is sitting up right in the middle there. So that is cool. So in total, if you have the Rat King figure, that's 8 rats that you'll have. Especially since we have 2 more with their tails curled up, so you can put those all over Rat King's body, the way he likes to have rats, you know, riding on him everywhere. Toast. All right, here are the last 3 items, the VHS tape, the slice of pizza, and this little copter drone. I had to look it up. It's called a tubular transport, and it is tiny. I'm used to them being bigger, like in the video games and stuff. So here are the Mousers. You get 4 complete Mousers, and then you get one that is slightly damaged right here. And then you have one that is almost complete, missing a foot. It is broken and has a mouse popping out its back, which makes sense because, you know, they eat mice or they eat rats, and then the rat goes into their body. So this one's destroyed and there's a rat inside. That's really funny. And then we get the one that is in pieces. Here's the broken head, the broken neck, and then the body that has like a spring coming out there. So that is some really cool detail. As far as the Mouser's articulation, they have the jaw that opens and closes. They have moving heads that turn, and they bend up and down, rotate. That's really cool. And then they have moving legs, and they have bending knees and bending feet. So you can get lots of cool articulation out of these mousers, get them in some cool poses, attacking some turtles, biting their hands and stuff like that. Rawr! So that is pretty cool. This is definitely a army builder pack, because you can, you know, buy a whole bunch and get a whole ton of rats and a whole ton of mousers. So that is really cool. The detail on these, it just looks great. You can see how bent up, slashed up they are. Of course, that's the funny, the happy rat coming out there. Is it they just reused the same head? Well, it doesn't have whiskers, but besides that, I think it is the same figure coming out of the mouser right there. But yeah, overall, just great. Great detail on here, making them look all mashed up, broken. It's fantastic. You know what I'm really looking forward to is the Comic-Con pack of human characters, and there's going to be the human Baxter Stockman, so it'll be great to be able to put him alongside the Mousers here. All right, there we go. So here's the entire pack that it comes with, aside from these two rats in the back here. I know the Mousers were only in like the first couple episodes of the cartoon show, then they never showed up again, but they are simply iconic to the Ninja Turtle brand for some reason. I think they are cool, cool, cool. So now look how far NECA has come. It's on the right, we have the original comic book styled Mouser. I believe this one came with April. And here we have this new Mouser based on the cartoon show. They both look fantastic, but this original one has like no articulation at all. The jaw does not open or anything. It is basically an accessory. Whereas these new ones are like full-on figures with great articulation and opening jaws. Now, similarly, let's compare it to the original Mouser toy from the 80s. Now, this one was one of my first Ninja Turtle toys, and I just love it, love it, love it. I think this was probably my fourth or fifth. My first one was Donatello, then Raphael, and then I think I got like Bebop or Rocksteady, and then I got this. So this one is a wind-up toy, but it doesn't seem to work anymore. But when it did work, it walked, and its mouth would open and close, and I thought that was amazing. You can see it is much bigger, and much less expensive than any of these other ones ever cost. So, being like $4 at retail. Anyway, there is a little bit of Mouser toy history. Unfortunately, I don't think I ever got any of the 2003 or 2012 Mouser toys, but here's what we do have, and toast. Hey friends, thanks for tuning in to this Turtly Tuesday today. Yeah, let's see. If you want to see more Ninja Turtle videos from this channel, just click on this playlist right there at the top. And then right below there is another video that YouTube thinks you would enjoy from this channel. Have a great day and toast.